So hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing well. So in this video I'm going to talk about with you how you can use the custom font in the Blender. Okay, so and guys, I have already downloaded some fonts. Here you can see I have some fonts here. Okay, here you can see there are some preview images also. Okay, so I have already downloaded some fonts, and if you want to these fonts, so I will put the link into the description, you can download from there free. Okay, so now without any further delay, now let's get started. So first of all, what I will do, I will go to my top view and I will press Shift A, and here I will add one text. Okay, then I will, after that I will press the tab and I will select the alt text, Control A, and I will wrote here Blender. Okay, and after that I will exit the edit mode. So now here you can see we have our text here, font here. Okay, and I'm just going to rotate it 90 degree exactly like that. Okay guys, and now if you want to change the font of your text, okay, so how you can change that? Because when you wrote anything in the Blender, this is showing the default font of the Blender. Okay, so here you can see when I click on it, so here we have a one option. Okay, it's called object data property. So when I click on it, so here you can see we have a one section is called font. Okay, so right now here you can see it's showing a font name b font and italic b font, bold and italic b font. B font means Blender font. Okay, this is Blender default font, and here you can see here we have a one option also. Here we can open font, means we can load our custom files also here from there. So how we can do this? So first of all, you have to just look your font, ki which kind of font you are importing, means this is regular, bold, italic, a bold and italic. So here you can see if I will click on my font, so this is the regular font. Okay, it's showing a regular font. So what I will do, I will just click on the regular. Okay, and I will find my file where I save it. Okay, then here you can see auto linker. So if I click on it and I will just click on it, so here you can see our Blender font is changed now. Okay, and if you want to see some depth on it, so you can increase the extrusion like that. Okay guys, here you can see how easily we can import it. Okay, so now I'm just going to copy this and I'm just keep beside it. So now we are going to import some another font also. So I'm just going to click on it, go here, and I will add some regular font. So here you can see we have another font here. How cool is it looking? Okay, and if you want to change anything, means, and if you want to change anything in from transform, means you can change the size as well. Okay, you can change the shear, means it's, you can make italic as well. Okay, but I don't know, sometimes it's sometimes it's useful, but and the main important thing that you can animate this. Okay, if you want to animate it, so I'm just going to show you how you can animate this. So I'm just going to press on that key. So here we have one key here, and after that I'm going to 50 and I will going to increase the size like that. Then after that I will click on again, then I will click on go to the 90 frame, and then I will click on 0 again, and here we go. So when I play the animation, so here you can see we have our animation. Okay, so right now I took lots of frame. Okay, that's why it's showing very slow motion. If you want to speed up your animation, so you can decrease the number of frame size. Okay, yeah, maybe you can do from here also. So you just have to go to the here, and right now it's showing frame rate is 24, so I'm just setting is 60 frame. So now it will be more faster. Okay guys, so now you got it how you can animate your font as well. Okay, and the main important thing that you can animate lots of things from here. You can animate the size also. Okay, and underline positions. So here you can see we can animate each and everything, and we have some paragraph also. So right now it's a left align. If you want to center align, you can do center align. Here you can see this is better sometime because so if you increase your size of your font, so now it will increase from the center. Okay, this is good because and we can change the vertical alignment as well. Okay, so it's basically when you can use that when you have lots of text on your scene, like a paragraph. So where you can use that. And here we have some character spacing. We can increase this spacing. And I told you we can animate each and everything. So for example, if we want to animate these things also, we can animate this like that. First of all, I just click on first frame, go to 30 frame, and I'm just going to increase the speed, increase the space, and then I will take a keyframe again, and then I'm going to copy the first frame and paste it. So as you can see, so we have a good animation here. Okay, if I will put the end frame 70, so as you can see we have a good animation here. So this is the good thing, we can change the, we can animate each and everything. Okay guys, you got it. So now I'm just going to import some another font also. So I'm just going to duplicate it and keep beside as well. And now I'm just going to change the font, and I'm using the some another font. So here you can see we have a very cool effect here. Okay, this is the font basically. Okay, and we have a that effect also. Okay, so I'm just going to copy this font again and keep beside, and I'm going to import another font just like this is looking cool. Okay, so let's talk about some more settings. So this is the offset basically, we can change the offset. This is the X offset and this is the Y offset. Okay, and we have some other setting also. Okay guys, so now I'm just going to change another font. So we have that font also. So here you can see how cool it is, it is looking. And the next video I will tell you how you can animate your font. Okay, how you can animate your font according to your path also. So we will do some cool animation in that video. Okay, so stay tuned with me guys, and subscribe my channel also. So we have some another font, see. So I think you got it how you can import your custom font in the Blender. Okay, and how you can change the settings. So if you here you can see we can increase the depth as well. Okay, so here we have a bevel. So if I will increase the depth bevel, here you can see we can make our font more smooth. We can increase the depth resolution. Okay, and we can take the any object as a bevel object. Okay, so that these settings I will talk about in the next video when I will teach you how you can animate the text. Okay, and this is the offset basically, this is the offset of the each and every fonts, each and every words. This is the extrusion, that is I told you before. Okay, and these setting I will not talk about right now. So this is the resolution preview, we can increase the preview. So it will be when we increase the preview, it will be look more smoother. Okay, and this is a fill mode. So basically what it does exactly, if I will set the back, so now we will see the fill into the back but not in the front. If I will set the front, so we will same thing, it's happen opposite. Okay, and if I will set the none, so it's look like that. Okay, so I'm just keep this both, and this is the fill deformed. Okay, I will also talk about that setting. Okay, how we can use that. So thanks for watching this video, guys. I hope you learned something in this video. If you learned something in this video, please hit the like button, hit the share button, and subscribe my channel also. And if you have any queries, if you have any suggestion, please let me know in the comment box. I will definitely reply your comment. So bye bye, take care, stay home.